Dear friends, we are right away going into the subject, and now I am going to explain you 3 marks. Surely it will come. This is regarding valuation of options. Two questions are being asked in the valuation of options. One is sensitivity analysis, and the other one is assumptions with regard to Black-Scholes model. One question on Monte Carlo theory. One problem on binomial model is coming. Therefore, all together is about 5 marks. This comes under valuation. First step is I would like to explain you how to remember. I am not going into too much theory. As I told you, this is a lecture which helps you to pass the exam. And how to remember in the exam. How I felt during the examination. In spite of having reasonably good knowledge, because I am teaching the CA final students, because a detailed teaching will be required. So I myself faced a lot of troubles. That's why from that angle I am explaining you. Now with regard to these questions, 4 marks that you are going to, 5 marks you are going to get. You go to page number 72, 73 of the CA Institute material that they have given, valuation techniques. Under that, the options. First I will go through page 73, and first step is let's read out, and then how to remember them. A basic idea I'll give you, and here first question: effects of variables on option values, and that means this is sensitivity analysis. That is what we are trying to check up. Then what is this sensitivity analysis? First I'll explain the logic. Once you capture that logic, you apply to all the situations. You must have that depth. And here, first question is call and puts. What is a call option? Briefly, I am explaining. It is a derivative. Option means, as you know, exercisable and you like it. It is like you are in, we can say you are in love with somebody. So that is called option. You want to, there is nothing called marriage. But share price, purchasing a share market, share, that is a marriage. You got to sell. Once you buy a share, then you have to sell. And here option means Tata Steel is there. Let us say the share price is 500. Now you believe that share price is going to go up. One thing is you can buy the share. 500 rupees you buy, let us say 10 shares. The share price go to 550. You get 500 rupees profit. Suppose the share price falls to 450, you lose 500 rupees. That is called share market. Primary market, secondary market dealing. But now there is what's called as option to that. Like curd is a derivative of milk. Ghee is a derivative of milk. If milk price goes up, curd price also will go up. So underlying asset value, that is Tata Steel share. So now I believe Tata Steel price is 400. Now it will go to 450. Instead of investing, let us say 10 shares, 4000 rupees, I would like to purchase the shares, the options, by paying a simple premium. Let's say the premium is 10 rupees. Because that depends again market forces of demand and supply. Suppose I buy options. 10 rupees premium I paid, and then the share price gone to 450, I'll get 50 rupees, the difference between I purchased at 400, a call option means, holder of a call means, for exercise price 400 means, if the share price goes up, he can sell it, exercise his option at 450, that means he's selling at 450 and he has purchased at 400, net result is 50 rupees. So that means when the share price is going on increasing, you get more money. If the exercise price is going up, then you get less money. Simple. Now you are a put option. It's just opposite of that. You are believing that share price is going to fall. You are a bull, a bear. A call holder of a call is a bull, believing that share prices will go up. Whereas the holder of a put option is a bear. He thinks the share prices will fall. So in all cases, premium paid is the loss for them. If the share price falls below 400 in a call option, you don't exercise it, you keep quiet. Unlike a share market, you have to exercise, otherwise you close the contract. But here, you just leave it. So, A put option is just opposite. If the share price is now 400, I have exercise price, purchase the call option, put option at 400. Now the share price at 370. So it means I sold at 400, I can buy at 400 and 370, 30 rupees is my profit. Now suppose if it goes up, if 370 becomes 380, then my value comes down. And similarly the exercise price, instead of 400 becomes 410, then I will get profit. That's all. It's very, very simple. You remember like this, first step. Now this question asked is, first question is increase in stock price, you know the answer. Increase in strike price, you also know. Third question is variance. Variance is a volatility. The share price is going to go widely fluctuating. That's called as a volatile share. Nobody will buy a share which fluctuates heavily. That is share, but option of that share is very, very profitable. A volatile share is very good for an option or derivative player, because suppose the share price is at 50 and it can touch 80 or 30. What I can do, I'll buy one call, one option, one put, both I'll buy at a time. My premium paid is 3 rupees, 2 rupees, 5 rupees. 5 rupees is my loss for this strategy. Now the share price goes to 80. Then what I will do, I'll exercise the call option. 50, 80, I'll get 30 rupees. 5 rupees I pay, 25 is my profit. Suppose the share price falls, then I'll exercise the put option. I'll ignore the call option. Therefore, volatility is favorable for share options. That is why third point. Time to expire, you remember, it is increase. It's good. And interest rates increase, this question is asked. When interest rate increases, you just remember call value will increase. When the call value is increased, this will decrease. Dividend paid. Actually, when you pay dividend, what happens is the price, 25 rupees, dividend is 2 rupees per share. It's actually 23. Understand, the share price is quoted at come. That's all. Now you read it once again. And one way of remembering. Another way is, because this better way, increase, decrease. Once you know the logic, they may ask you decrease in stock price. What will happen, they will ask. You read for increase in stock price. So you should be logical and then be convinced. This question 2 marks, sure. So therefore you proceed in this. Now the next is assumptions underlying the Black-Scholes model. Remember that will also come for 2 marks. What are the questions? Black-Scholes models assumes that this follows European model. The options are based on European model. What are European model? The option every month it is changing. Every 2 months, every 3 months. This is a January model, let us say. If it is European option, you can purchase that Tata Steel at 400 on 1st, 5th, 10th, 12th. But exit will be only on 31st January, at the expiry period only. So in case of European model, entry is okay anytime, but exit is on a fixed time. That is called European model. But an American model option is you can exit or enter anytime. That is the difference. Because during the month of the every call options, put options will be for a particular period, and that period you can enter anytime, but exit is in the end of the period. That is European model. And if it is anytime entry and anytime exit is called as a this thing. Option is one thing where you can exercise at your will. If it is profitable, you will exercise. If it is not profitable, you keep quiet. But futures contract, derivative contracts, you have to exercise only if it close the contract. That is the point we have to understand.